Hello and welcome to the next online video class. Students, in the previous video we had started chapter 13, that is direct and inverse proportion, and in that we had discussed about direct proportion, and we had done 6 questions of 13.1 exercise, and last 4 questions were given as homework. You must have found the problem in solving in the calculation of 7th and 9th question. Others are simple. These questions you will find, I will share the PDF with it, so you can solve your problem over there. So now today we will discuss the next topic, that is inverse proportion. So let us start with the topic, that is inverse proportions. We will understand this with the help of some situations or examples. Let us see the first example. There is a girl, Sunaina. She daily goes to school on foot, and she takes 30 minutes to reach the school if she walks with the speed of 3 km per hour. And if she increases the speed 6 km per hour, then she takes only 15 minutes. In 15 minutes, she reaches the school. But if she goes on cycle with the speed of 9 km per hour, it takes only 10 minutes. And if she goes on car, only 2 minutes are taken to reach the school with 45 km per hour speed. You know that in car speed is increased. So here you have seen that when speed is increasing, the time taken is decreasing. When she was going to school with 3 km per hour speed, it was 30 minutes to be taken to reach the school. And when she increased the speed 6 km per hour, and the time is less, the time taken to reach the school is less, 15 minutes only. And if the speed is more increased, 9 km per hour, then she takes only 10 minutes, and the speed is increased to 45 km per hour, she takes only 2 minutes to reach the school. So now let us understand this, the relation of proportion and ratio. Now you will see here, when the speed was 3 km per hour, time taken was 30 minutes only. And when the speed is doubled, time is halved. And when the speed is 3 times increased, and then time taken is 1/3 only, decreased it is. And if the speed is increased 15 times, the time taken is decreased 15 times, decreased 1/15 only. So here you can see, when speed is increasing, time taken is decreasing. You remember in the direct proportion we have seen that both quantities, both items were increasing or both were decreasing, but here it is the opposite reaction. When speed is increasing, time is decreasing. So here you can see, speed is 3 km per hour, time is 30. 33 is 90. Speed into time, when we take this, it is constant, 90. And 15 into 6 is also 90. 10 into 9 also 90. 45 into 2 is also 90. So means distance covered is same, because formula of distance is speed into time, and distance will not change. As the speed will increase, time taken is getting less. Now let us see the next situation. There is a farmer. He has to feed 5 horses. Daily he feed them, and their food lasts for 15 days. 5 horses food, provision of food he is having for 15 days. But then he brought 3 more horses, and the food is same, the stock of food is same, and how long will it last, that food, how long will it last? Naturally, when 5 horses were there, they were eating that much food for 15 days. When 3 more horses are there, what will happen? The food will last for less number of days. So see the situation. Number of horses were 5, then number of days food lasts for 15,
And when the horses are 8, then number of days is 10. For 10 days, those 8 horses can eat the food. So here you can see, when number of horses are increasing, number of days are decreasing. For number of days their food will last, that is decreasing. So here you can
see the difference between direct and inverse proportion. In the direct proportion, there was direct relation between the ratios, and in this situation there is an opposite relation between the both the quantities. Now here some situations are given, some situations in our day-to-day life are given. We have to tell them that what type of proportion it is, whether direct or indirect. So here are given, analyze each situation one by one and say what kind of proportions they are. First is number of workers on a job and time taken to complete the job. So as we have done, number of workers. Suppose two workers can do a job in 4 days, then if the number of workers are increased, naturally work will finish in less number of days. So it is the indirect proportion. Area of cultivated land and crop harvested. This is the direct relation. Why? Because when the area will be increased, the quantity of crop will also increase. And when area is decreased, quantity of crop harvested is decreasing. So it is the direct proportion. The time taken for a fixed journey and speed of the vehicle. Students, remember, time and speed are having opposite relation. Opposite relation means they are indirectly proportionate. Time will less when speed is increased, and when speed is decreased, as you have seen over there in the situation, when speed is decreased, time taken will be getting more. The time taken for a journey and the distance traveled in the uniform speed. So this is the direct relation, because distance will depend on the time. As more time you will take, the more distance you will cover. If you will take the less time, the less distance you will cover. So speed and time are inversely proportionate, and time and distance are directly proportionate. Now let us start with exercise 13.2. First question is, which of the following are in inverse proportion? We have to choose which situations are in inverse proportion. First is the number of workers on a job and the time to complete the job. Yes, it is inverse, because as the number of workers will increase, they will take less time to complete the job. And if number of workers are less, then the time to complete the job will be more. Second part is the time taken for a journey and the distance traveled in a uniform speed. Uniform speed means speed is still, it is not changing. So time taken and distance, as I told you earlier, that time and distance are directly proportionate. It is direct proportion. Area of cultivated land and the crop harvested, this we have done earlier. These are also directly proportionate. The time taken for a fixed journey and the speed of the vehicle. Time and speed are inversely proportionate. The population of a country and the area of land per person. If population will be more, they will get less place to live. And if the population is less, then they will get more place to live in. So it is inverse proportionate. Let us move to second question. In a television game show, the prize money of rupees 1 lakh is to be divided equally amongst the winners. Complete the following table and find whether the prize money given to an individual winner is directly or inversely proportionate. Proportional to the number of winners. So students, only 1 lakh amount is there, which they have to divide amongst the winners. Number of winners, if it is 1 only, that person will get 1 lakh rupees. If the number of winners is 2, then each will get 50,000. Amount will get less. And if the number of winners are 4, what we will do? Divide 1 lakh by 4. It will be how much? 25,000 each. If the number of winners are 5, then divide 1 lakh by 5. It will be 20,000 each. Similarly, divide by 8, then divide by 10, then divide by 20. Every time that 1 lakh rupees amount will be divided according to the number of winners. Because we have to divide amongst the winners. Only 1 lakh. As the number of winners will be increasing, they will get less amount. Right? So, this is inversely proportionate. Question was, we have to tell that this situation, individual winner is directly or inversely proportional to the number of winners. It is inversely proportional. And you have to complete this table. Third question. Students, here you can see Rahman is making a wheel using spokes. These spokes are in between the wheel. He wants to fix equal spokes in such a way that the angles between any pair of consecutive spokes are equal. Angle between them are equal. So, help him by completing the following table. So, as you know that complete circle is of 360 degree. In first diagram, there are three spokes, means three angles. So, 360 will be divided by 3, it will be 120 each. Now, here in the second figure, you will see that there are 6 spokes. So, 360 divided by 6, each angle will be of 60 degree. Then, next, in the third wheel, there are 8 spokes. So, 360 divided by 8, it will be how much? 45 degree. Yes. 360 divided by 8. So, like that, we can complete this table also. Number of spokes are 4. 360 divided by 4, it is 90. Divided by 6, it will be 60. Then divide 360 by 8. Then divide 360 by 10. Then divide 360 by 12. And you will complete this table. So, this is the angle between a pair of consecutive spokes. Remember that the whole circle is central angle, complete angle is of 360 degree. So, that's why we have to divide that 360 degree into the number of spokes. According to that, number of angles will be formed over there. Next is, of this question only, first part is, are the number of spokes and the angles formed between the pairs of consecutive spokes in inverse proportion? Yes, they are in inverse proportion, because as the number of spokes are increasing, angle between them is decreasing. Calculate the angle between a pair of consecutive spokes on a wheel with 15 spokes. So, the method is same, 360 divided by 15. Where you will divide 360 by 15, it will be 24 degree. How many spokes would be needed if the angle between a pair of consecutive spokes is 40 degree? And vice versa again, 360 divided by 40, you will get number of spokes. Let us do question number 4. If a box of sweets is divided among 24 children, they will get 5 sweets each. How many would each get if the number of children reduced by 4? So, students, there are 24 children and each child is getting 5 sweets. And if 4 children are reduced, means 20 children are there only, then how many sweets each will get? So, let us see how to do. Here you have to make box as you have done in previous exercise. With each question, we have to make the box. One row is number of children, the other row it is number of sweets. If when 24 children are there, number of sweets each will get 5. And when 20 children are there, 24 minus 4, because 4 are reduced, 20 children are there, then how many each will get? That we have taken x in place of that. So here we have not to cross multiply, because it is inversely proportionate. As the number of children will increase, number of sweets will decrease. So here we have to vertical multiply, not cross multiply.
20 multiplied by x is equal to 24 multiplied by 5. We can write any number first. 24 into 5 is equal to 20 into x also we can write. But it will be easy to solve when you will take x term first. Terms of x, where x is there, that if you write first, it will be easy to solve. So 20 into x is equal to 24 into 5. 20 is multiplied by x, that is the variable, then it will be divided on the other side, and after cancellation 6 is coming, so each child will get 6 sweets. Next question is, a farmer has enough food to feed 20 animals in his cattle for 6 days. How long would the food last if there were 10 more animals in his cattle? Students, this you have done in the situation which I had given earlier in the starting of the video. A farmer has enough food to feed 20 animals. 20 animals he can feed for 6 days. He is having sufficient food for 20 animals and it will last for 6 days. But when 10 more animals added to his cattle, then how long that food will go? How long will that food will last? So let us see how to do. It is also the inverse proportion. How inverse? Because number of animals is 20 and the food will last for 6 days. When 10 more animals came there, then 20 plus 10 is 30. 30 animals now. How long will it go? That we have to find out. Naturally, when there are more animals have come, that food will go for less number of days. So it is the inverse proportion. How to do vertical multiply? 30 into x is equal to 20 into 6. So 30 will go down in the denominator on the other side. After cancellation, 4 is there. Then the food will last for 4 days only. Very simple to solve. Very simple. So now students, question number 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 11. That you will do yourself. I will only explain question number 10 because it is looking little bit different. Two things we have to solve and I will tell you the method how to write these two things in one box only and how to solve it. So let us see. Two persons could fit new window in a house in 3 days. According to first situation, one of the person fell ill before the work started and how long would the job take now? How many persons would be needed to fit the windows in one day? What is given that two persons can fit the window in a house in 3 days? When out of those two persons, when fell ill, then how long the work will go? And if we want to finish that work in only one day, then how many persons are needed? Let us see how to solve this question. Question number 10 is number of persons and number of days. We will write in the two columns, two rows. Two persons can finish in 3 days. One person get ill. Only one person is left. How many days they will take? So here, because it is the inverse proportion that we know, that two persons can finish in 3 days, then if the number of persons will get less, they will take more days. So you know that in inverse proportion, we use vertical multiply. 1 into x is equal to 2 into 3. 2 3 is a 6, x into 1 is x. So they will take, that person will take only 6 days. Then in the next situation, when we have to finish in one day, day is 1 and number of persons we have to find out, that we have taken y. Because x we have already taken in first situation. Any alphabet we can take there. 1 into y is equal to 2 into 3, that is 6. So 6 persons can finish the work in one day. This was all. Rest of the questions you will do yourself and you will solve yourself. Students, you will get the PDF link in the comment box of these two videos which we have posted over there. And here our chapter is being finished. The last thing is mind map. Let me explain this mind map also. So two topics are there only, direct proportion and inverse proportion. In direct proportion, it is the
direct relation means x divided by y will be equal to k upon 1. When we will cross multiply, this will be x is equal to ky. So this is the direct relation. In inverse proportion, x1 upon x2 is equal to y1 upon y2. That is the vertical multiplication. Vertical. So xy is equal to k. This is the relation of inverse proportion. So here this is the mind map. And here the chapter is finished. Now we will meet in the next video for with the new chapter and the new topic. This chapter should be done in your FAIR notebooks properly and thoroughly, and all questions should be solved over there. Till then, goodbye.